You got divorced, many years ago, and after that, you made the comment that you'll never marry again. What made you change your mind?
So I got to know Birgit, who is my wife. I knew her for 8 months, or we dated 8 months, and I had a kidney problem. And I asked my son Lucas if he would test to donate me a kidney. He came to Vienna, did a test, and his kidney did not fit that the doctors say it is good to put in me. And then Birgit said, I'm gonna do the test. And then I said, why would I do the test? Because I would donate your kidney. I said, you will never ever donate me a kidney, because why? I'm ill, I know you now since 8 months, why? I will never do that. I do the test. She did the test and she did fit. And then she said, I want to donate the kidney. I said, no. And then she gave me for about 3 months always the same impression. I do it for you because I love you, and this is the way it is. She never was frightened or asked questions, is it dangerous for me? What can happen to me? Never. It was just a pure approach, I will do it. And then after a long time thinking about it, then we went. Then when they pushed her away in the hospital to start the operation, I was praying that please nothing should happen to her. Nothing, because things, an operation is always an operation. And then I got her kidney, and now this kidney works 100% right. I have the same creatinine level like you have, if you're fit. And it is fantastic. So after 4 years, I married her, but because not of the kidney donation, because I knew that she was the right woman to marry. And then we got twins, Max and Mia. So I was really lucky that all these things happened today. And with my Marlene, which I have a very good relation with her. Birgit and Marlene get on very well in Ibiza.
And how does that work? Because I understand the three of you will go out together sometimes.
Yeah, but it is mainly to say, first of all, Birgit, yes, but Marlene has always been, like I explained before, she always wants that the other people are happy. She doesn't give any restrictions to anybody because of her behalf. So there are very few people around the world who say, I want you to be happy, and I put myself happy in another position. And therefore, there was no problem at all that she will get on with Birgit, and she did from the first day. And for Easter, for example, we have all the kids together in Marlene's house. Lucas has a kid, Matthias has 2 kids, so we're all together celebrating Easter in a fantastic way, everybody put together.
So you mentioned you have 2 twins, Max and Mia, a boy and girl. You have older children as well. To what extent, looking back, would you have liked to have been around more for your older kids, for them in the same way you are?
This is a very theoretical question, because it was not possible. Because the times with Marlene and Lucas and Matthias was my racing, was my job. To make it simple, and I had to be different to be able to fulfill my job, like I explained in the beginning. Mm-hmm. Now I have more time, I have no risk at all, and I enjoy my little kids that they grow up with me or I grow up with them, because it keeps me young, I have to say, and it is fantastic what my life is today. But I do not regret the past, because I had no choice in the past. It was different times, and this is the way it was. With Lucas and Matthias, I have a fantastic relationship, so everything in the end worked out very well.
What's it like for you now, having kids later on in life?
Fantastic. I mean, it is unbelievable, because every day there's new experience with them. You grow up the way they speak their language, the way they understand things. It is every day a new positive surprise.
What do you like most about it?
Like most about it, that I really feel them strongly. I think it's the other way around too. We have this typical father and mother relationship. Birgit freaks out of something they have done, not me. And then they look at me, and if I think if Birgit has done a little bit too much, then I always say, and then the kids laugh again.
So you're kind of the soft one.
Yeah, I'm 100% the soft one, because she's a tough cookie with them, and therefore we have this good relationship. I mean, the kids like me very much. Birgit says, if I pick them up from school, which I had to do yesterday, if I have time, I do it. And then the kids say to me, now we go and eat ice cream. Sure, we go and eat ice cream. I picked them up from school, now we have ice cream. So we come home. Where have you been? Mia says, ice cream with daddy. You want ice cream? I told you, there is no ice cream because too much sugar and forward and backwards. Birgit, hello. If you make me responsible, pick the kids up from school, which normally I don't do, I decide then what is good for us. So we go and eat ice cream. If you send me again, I do the same thing again. But this, I guess, is normal marriage discussion.